Breakfast.
Disgusting.
We haven't got our Michelin star yet.
And it's cold again.
We'll deduct you from your bill.
Oi, when am I going to see my solicitor?
Well, you're up in court first thing, so you'll see him there.
Then I'll be out, right?
That'll be up to the magistrate.
Yeah, but I help you.
Trouble is, you were caught red-handed.
My solicitor said he'd sort it.
Well, you'll be all right then, won't you?
They brought the other two in yet?
I wouldn't know.
What's taking so long?
This has got to be a short straw on a Monday morning.
Not busy enough for you?
Surfing out drunk, serving up breakfast. It's just what I joined up for. Who else is up for court this morning?
Apart from Yellen, Gordon and Thomas. Nice little van load.
Any unit, Sierra Oscar Deal, Limefield Road School, suspects on.
Sierra Oscar 8-5 receiving, we'll take that.
For those of you lucky enough to have had the weekend off, robbery at the embassy after a sellout rock concert on Saturday night. Security van arrives early Sunday morning. Two guards go in and are met with a reception committee.
Were they armed?
Coshes. One of the guards got bashed about a bit. How is he, Tosh?
He's still in hospital, Gov.
The third guard, waiting in the van, he got worried, raised the alarm, sharpish. The area car cornered the getaway by Limefield Road School. Two of the blaggers got away on foot. The third, Terry Yelland, he was arrested.
Do they have anything to say?
Yeah, spent yesterday singing like a canary. Named his two accomplices. He goes up to court today. You can take that one, Danny. You want a 3-day lay down in custody. Give us a chance to follow up his two mates, who were not at home in their beds when we called early this morning.
So why did Yellen cough?
Because it's not his show, and he doesn't want to go down alone.
An understandable attitude.
Apart from the fact he's only just turned 18.
First time in grown-up court.
Exactly. He's saying the others led him astray.
A real jerker, eh?
Except that he's got a juvenile record longer than my arm.
What about the other two?
Les Wilson, he's done time for this sort of thing before. The other one, Ian Sharp, we don't know. We soon will.
I noticed these two guys standing by the gates, looking in. But when I went out to see what they wanted, they disappeared round the back.
Which way did they go?
They went up that way. I didn't like the look of them at all.
Mike!
Fresh air.
Make the most of it.
Just a second.
Go.
Just wait there, please.
All right, Bob.
All right. Take a seat.
I don't know what all the fuss is about. We were just messing around.
I knew they were up to something. I knew it. Probably the computer they were after.
Is he all right?
Yeah, it's a nasty gash. I've called for an ambulance.
Oh, I'll see you back there later. Come on, Stumpy.
Right, just hold that.
Sergeant.
Mrs. K.
I believe you're handling one of my probationers.
Yeah, Terry Yelland, he's in talking to his solicitor now. Mr. Corliss.
How serious is it?
Well, serious enough. Security guard knocked about.
I really thought we were getting through to him.
Well, not a bad lad, eh? Just easily led.
I gather he's not been charged yet.
We're applying to detain him in police custody for the moment. He's been very cooperative.
Well, that's something to be grateful for, I suppose.
Yeah.
Now, don't worry. You need all that to me. All yours, Sergeant.
Jill?
Didn't you think I'd be here, Terry?
Terence Yelland, to court one.
Time to go.
I'll talk to you afterwards.
I don't know why you're arresting me. It's his fault.
What was?
Breaking the window.
We'll sort that out later, Mr. Wilson.
But I'm just a victim here. He shoved me against that window.
So why did you try and run off when we came to your rescue then?
Well, I wasn't going to let him get away. Just leave me landing in it, was I?
With Yellen's accomplices still at large and the stolen money unrecovered, a warrant of further detention is crucial to our investigation.
Thank you, Sergeant. Mr. Corliss?
I can only reiterate that my client deeply regrets letting himself be enticed into this enterprise, as he has proved by his full cooperation with the police. Ma'am, there is simply no reason for him not to be charged and released on bail at this stage.
Yes.
Criminal damage at Limefield Road School, Sarge. Broken window. Looks like attempted burglary.
Oh, come on.
Steve's just taken his accomplice down to the hospital.
It was a mistake. It was just an accident. We were walking by
the glass just fell through, yeah?
You can explain it all later. Name?
Jim. Jim Dixon.
Stand up, Mr. Yelland.
Mr. Yelland, in consideration of the fact that further arrests and identification parades are anticipated, and that further charges may result, we are granting a warrant of further detention to the police. This means that you will be held in police custody for a maximum of 3 days, reviewed at the usual interval.
But you can't! No, you said I'd get back!
Terry, take it easy. Sit down.
You gotta do something! Mr. I'm not Yelland, getting back there!
Terry!
Terry, come to
stop it!
Stop it! Terry!
Dave?
Yep.
That body Jarvis brought in.
Dixon.
Acting a bit shifty, wasn't he? Nothing on him to confirm his ID.
You reckon he's trying it on?
See if his description rings any bells with Donna.
About 2 minutes. He was running up Waterman's Road. Can you circulate it? Thanks. Oh, and you better let the DI know. Yeah. Cheers.
All right, Mr. Dixon.
Yeah, that's him from the robbery yesterday.
Yeah, Donna recognised him right away from the description.
Did CID pull him?
Are you kidding?
This isn't going to help things at all, is it?
He was sure he was going to get bail. He was relying on it.
Well, maybe he shouldn't have got his hopes up.
I tried to explain. He thought if he cooperated, he'd be okay. He is terrified of going to prison.
Oh, a stunt like this isn't going to help things, is it? Have you got a moment?
Of course.
Yeah. Oh, and if he contacts you, Mr. Corliss, try talking some sense into him this time. When did you last see Terry?
Last Wednesday. He comes in once a fortnight.
So what can you tell me about his domestic circumstances?
He's living in a bedsit we found for him.
Anyone he's likely to contact? A girlfriend?
Well, there has been a girl recently. Quite a stabilising influence. But I don't know much about her. Her name's Sally, and she works in a travel agent.
Any idea where she lives?
That's all I know. I'm sorry, I can't be more help.
Yeah. All right, Mr. Dixon.
What is this, London Zoo?
I'm just checking that you're comfortable.
Well, I'll be all right if I had a moment's peace.
Well?
Yeah, that's him all right, isn't it? Someone you chase.
Climbed out of the railings before I could grab him.
Yeah. Well, of course, they split up on us all, didn't they? Round the back of the school. I collared the young lad, Yelland, and Tony, and he went after him. The older one must have doubled back.
Yeah, we think he might be down in the hospital with Steve.
Fits the description, all right.
Did you actually see these three leave the getaway car?
No, they ran into the school by the time we got there.
So who had the cash box?
That's a point.
I mean, Yelland reckons that Sharp got away with it.
He certainly wasn't carrying anything when I chased him.
No, none of them were.
So, what happened to the money? I mean, it wasn't in the car, and it wasn't with them when you spotted them.
So they stashed it. That's probably what they're doing back at the school.
Exactly. And as Yellen's just done a runner 15 minutes ago from the court, I suggest we get someone down there fast. I mean, with 50 grand lying around, Christmas could come early for someone.
Opened up about 7:30.
You check the grounds when you get in?
Of course.
Did you find anything or notice anything unusual this morning?
Can't say I did.
Are you sure?
What is it you're looking for?
A green plastic case about this big.
I think I would have noticed that lying around.
Could it have been thrown through an open window?
This building was locked up tight last Friday. I checked every room myself.
Then perhaps you'd like to show us around the grounds.
This way.
Now this I'm an expert on. Guided tours of schools.
Fond of school, were you, Mr. Sharp? Or should I say Mr. Dixon?
We were taking a shortcut, that's all.
Where to?
The shop's over the back, going to get some fags.
So why were you loitering around outside the school? Choosing your moment?
We were just talking.
How come Mr. Wilson managed to put his arm through a window?
He was leaning against it, looking in.
Forgot to bring a brick, did he?
We weren't breaking in. It was an accident.
Where were you around 9 o'clock yesterday morning?
What's that got to do with anything?
I'm interested.
Well, sleeping, I suppose.
I don't wish to appear personal. But was there anyone with you who could verify that?
I've heard about you, look. You'll twist what I say round.
Just want to get things cleared up, Ian.
I'm not saying nothing more.
This your first job, Ian? Who talked you into it? Terry Yellen? He'd tell you it'd be easy. Bit of a laugh. Only now it's robbery and GBH. And no one's laughing. Look, anyone can fall into temptation, Ian. Don't make it worse for yourself.
Terry Yellen, you say?
Flat 5. Have a warrant to search the premises. Oh,
makes no odds to me. He's never here half the time.
But he does live here, doesn't he?
Social services pays the rent. That's all I know about. Kind of tenant I like.
So when did you last see him?
Heard him, more like. Oh, playing music in the middle of the night. About a week ago, I suppose.
Any idea who she might be?
He's never brought her around here.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
He wants to exercise his right to silence. He can do it in the cells.
He knows he's not going to talk his way out of it.
Well, he's been a good boy, hasn't he? Doing what his brief tells him. I mean, what's he got to worry about? Only the word of two police witnesses.
Well, let's see how he reacts when we get a security guard to pick him out in an identity parade.
Go.
Oh, what's the word on Yellen?
Nothing at the address he's given. Looks like somebody just dumps his stuff.
How about the girlfriend?
This could be her. I'll run it through the system. I did that check with the embassy. Apparently Les Wilson has worked there in the past, the barman.
Sacked for having his hand in the till, was he?
Well, it explains how he knew when the concert takers were going to be picked up.
It also explains why he stayed in the motor. Didn't want to be recognised.
Tony and Reg reckon they were out of sight for about 30 seconds. And when they caught up with them, they were heading out of here towards the playing fields minus the money.
Well, not many places to hide a large cash box. Is there short of time?
Use your imagination.
I'm telling you, I'm straight now. I had enough of a taste last time.
4 years, wasn't it?
Yeah, don't remind me.
I thought you'd have learnt your lesson.
I have, Mr. Burns. I've got 3 kids now. Last one was born when I was still inside.
Yeah? Well, if you've got anything to do with this, they'll be married with kids of their own next time you see them.
I'm telling you, it weren't me. I know nothing about it.
Well, let's look at your movements this weekend. Let's start with Saturday evening.
I was in the boozer, where else?
Yeah, which one and with whom?
I was with Jerry and Jim and Andy, and it was the Devonish Arms in Solihull.
Solihull?
I've been away all weekend.
So it was your twin brother, was it?
What?
Hanging around the embassy Sunday morning.
Oh, you must be hard up.
Yeah, you've been identified.
I don't do that sort of stuff no more. There's no money in it.
Oh, there was in this one. And I have it on very good information. It was you who sussed it out.
You're making it up.
Seem to have a lot of enemies, Mr. Wilson. If they're not grassing you up, they're throwing you through glass windows.
There's nothing up there.
We're running out of places to look.
Maybe they buried it.
In 30 seconds flat.
We've looked everywhere else.
Come on, you're a desperate robber with the police right behind you and 50k in your hands. What do you do with it?
I've got it. The manhole. It's got to be there.
Chances are that hasn't been dislodged for years.
Look, it's the only place left. Are they waterproof, these cases?
Here you are, Mr. Burnside. Names of all the people I saw over the weekend.
The least I would have expected from a seasoned professional like yourself, Les. Thought you'd have a tidy little alibi arranged.
I resent the implication.
Don't worry, we'll check it out. Always pleased to go through the motions. Make sure you do name checks on all of them, Danny.
You've got nothing on me. You pulled me on my form.
There's only one problem with getting young kids to do your dirty work, Les. I mean, they're keen. I'm always pleased to have your experienced eyes suss them out a tasty little tickle. I mean, they take all the risks while you park your aged bones in the motor.
Give me a break.
Only trouble is, when they get nicked, they've got less to lose. Can always plead youth and innocence.
Which is why I took early retirement.
The way I see it, Les, the only thing that can mitigate your circumstances would be the recovery of the money.
I wish I could help.
See, it seems a bit puzzling to me why you and Mr. Sharp would be so stupid as to be found at the scene of the getaway the day after the blag. Doesn't that seem a bit puzzling to you, Danny?
Astounding.
All I've had so far is two cock and bull stories.
God told you.
Which makes me think that the money was dumped.
Let's hope Yelland isn't walking off with it right now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, didn't I mention that? Yelland escaped from custody this morning. Mr. Sharp wasn't too pleased either. Don't worry, Liz. I'm sure we'll find it before he does.
So, how'd the treasure hunt go?
Nothing, Gov.
Well, it's got to be there.
Believe you me, we left no stone unturned.
Oh, I don't believe this.
Well, maybe they chucked it from the car before they were run to ground.
Oh, yeah, maybe they stopped off and paid it into a cash point machine. Any news on Yellen?
Still trying to get a lead on the girlfriend.
I left Tosh at the school in case he turns up there.
Well, let's hope he does. Listen, can you find out how long it's going to take to set up an ID parade for Sharp and Wilson?
Gov.
Do you want Sharp out again?
No, let them both stew for a bit.
Well, have we got time for that?
Something tells me we won't have to wait very long.
So, feeling a bit more talkative now, then, Mr. Sharp?
D.I. Burnside enters, 12:55 p.m.
Obviously not.
Well, I know what's going to happen to me.
Well, we know you were there, Ian. You've been identified by two police officers running away from the getaway motor, and one of the security guards reckons he can pick you out in an ID parade. The one who's still walking about, that is.
I didn't knock no guard about. We'd have been out of there if Terry hadn't started laying into him.
And now he's on the loose and you're stuck in here.
I've never done anything like this before. I weren't out to hurt anyone. Terry just went mad.
Well, he's an excitable boy.
He said it would be a clean snatch.
Robbery's a dirty business, whatever anyone says.
If you got the money back, would it make a difference?
It would be viewed favourably by the courts.
He's at the school.
Well, it must be well hidden, because we've been looking.
I can show you.
Come on! Oi! Oi, oi, oi!
All right, what's the problem?
I want to see Burnside.
I've told you, he's out.
It's important, it's about the money.
You'll have to wait.
You tell him I want to see him!
We ran down here and round there. We could hear the sirens, we knew we ain't got long. So Les was yelling a dump it. So we were looking for a place and there was nowhere.
Yeah, we worked that one out.
And then Les had a flash.
He looked up there.
Well, the ladder's still out. Give us an hour here.
Terry gave me a leg up and I slung it over the side.
Hang on, that's right here.
So when Wilson went through the window this morning,
I was helping him to climb up, but he fell down.
Careful, Tosh.
Yeah, all right.
Anything? Nothing.
It's got to be there. That's definitely the place.
Hey, hang on a minute.
There's marks on the surface here. They look like something heavy's been dragged along it or thrown against it. I didn't see them earlier.
Well, it's got to be. I know it. This is definitely the place.
Could Wilson have pulled a fast one?
I never let him out of my sight all night.
Well, maybe he made a phone call, gave someone the nod.
No phone calls, nothing.
Yellen was in custody all night. And we've had this place covered since he escaped.
It's got to be there. It's just got to.
Don't understand it.
Nothing.
Well, maybe that'll teach you to leave your valuables lying around.
He's feeling neglected, wants a word.
He can wait.
I want to see someone! You can just shut it, Les. Oh, nobody's interest. Right. They're on to you.
I'll have you.
If you'd have taken us where we wanted to go instead of driving us down dead ends, we'd be all right.
Get off and brain! We wouldn't be here!
Quiet!
You little scrope, I'll have you, you little scrope!
You still think Sharp could be lying, then?
Maybe not. But then who got that money?
Sharp and Wilson were never out of each other's sight.
Yeah, and Yellen was with us. Somebody got word out to a fourth party.
Like he said, the money should be there. I was going to tell you myself, Mr. Burnside. I was going to cooperate.
Yeah, but it's a bit late now, isn't it?
Well, it wouldn't let me see you.
Anyway, cooperation doesn't come into it if the money's gone.
It sticks me up, thieving little scumbags.
I'd like to know how.
I'd like to know how. What does it matter how? We're in it together. You picked that little tosser up yet?
Oh, Yelland? No, we haven't tried him.
Have you tried his girl?
Who would that be?
His new bit. Posh bird. Never stops talking about
her. Her name, Liz?
Sally Corliss. You go and see her. When you find him, you give him one from me.
It's been staring us in the face.
Gav?
Wilson and Sharp were together all night. Yellen was under lock and key, so it must have been someone from outside. Who's the only other person any of them have communicated with?
Yellen's solicitor.
Exactly. Name of?
Owen Corliss.
Sergeant.
Mr. Corliss. This is DC Lyons.
Hello. How do you do? I take it this is about Terry Yellen.
That's right.
Should I be worrying about my fee?
We'll catch up with him. Can you help us with a few details?
Of course. Sit down.
How well do you know Mr. Yellen?
As well as one knows people in these circumstances. The sudden enforced intimacy with their lives and problems.
How long have you known him?
Since yesterday, when he asked me to represent him.
How did he come to pick you?
I believe he got my name from one of my other clients. Is there some problem, Sergeant?
Well, that depends on how much Terry Yellen confided in you about the events of yesterday morning.
Well, I can hardly discuss that with you now, can I, Sergeant? Legal privilege, is it not?
Well, not if you acted on the information by conveying it to other people or handling stolen goods.
What are you suggesting?
Who is Sally Corliss?
My sister.
Does she know Mr. Yellen?
All right. That's where he got my name.
Why did you say it was another client?
Well, I'm hardly going to boast about my sister being involved with the likes of him, am I?
So you didn't approve of Mr. Yellen?
My sister lives her own life.
And does that run to aiding a fugitive, handling stolen goods?
Wait a minute.
I hope you give favourable family rates.
Look, Sally doesn't know anything about it. It's nothing to do with her.
Doesn't know anything about what?
Look, I've had a bad year. I've been under a lot of pressure, money-wise. I suppose Terry knew about that from Sally. He was offering me the solution on a plate. He told me where the money was. Just wait until dark and go to the school. What would you have done?
First rule.
Right. Sally Corliss?
Yeah.
Police.
Oh, look. Oi! Come here, you! Come here! You want to watch that? You could do yourself an injury. So,
go,
where's the money?
No!
Where's the money?
I don't know what you mean.
Where's the money?
Go.
Get down there before it goes anywhere else. And as for you,
how'd you know I was here? Who told you?
You should know by now. You can't trust no one in this business.